All right, back with another rapid game. Old trusty E4, and it looks like we're gonna get another Carlcon. My last video I uploaded, we versed the Carlcon. So whenever I verse the Carlcon, I always play the advanced variation. So I will continue to do that today. And we'll see how it goes. Okay. So far, typical stuff. I was expecting this check. I guess another way to play. I don't know why he would bring out that knight before bringing his bishop out. But to each his own. Okay, so his idea is to get this knight here, bring the queen here. I really should study how to play against the Carlcon, but I just haven't. I really just haven't. So I'm just going to play probably what I typically would play. Then I'm going to need to bring this bishop. Bishop here is fine. And if he wants to, take here, that's fine as well. I'm just gonna castle. Okay. Now, let's bring this to the open file. Well, not open, but just about. Oh my goodness. And I did not notice that he was attacking that twice, but it's fine. Gonna have to go here, defending this. Could have just taken with the knight as well. So what is he gonna play? If I take here, he's gonna push this. Then go here. Take. And this is a passed pawn. Well, I mean, it's already a passed pawn. I think this is fine. Okay. That's how he wants to play it. Then I could go. No. How do I want to play this? Let's play here. I don't think I want to trade queens because he just set himself up for this discovery. So let me just play here so I have this escape route. And if he keeps his queen there, okay, he doesn't. But if he did, it would have allowed me to play here. So take his pawn. Threatening to play checkmate. So I will defend. Okay, and he makes this move. Starting to take this pawn. My opponent's playing quite fast, so I just gotta be careful. But I just gotta defend everything. I don't think he has any checks anymore. Okay, yeah, he goes for this. I can't play this now, but I can, no, can't play that. Or actually, I could just take the pawn with my queen. That's fine. Now I'm threatening his bishop. Okay. What is up with my background music here? I'm gonna just turn this off real quick. I don't know what's going on with that. So let's see. What do I want to play here now? I could just bring this on the 7th rank. And I mean, he's not really threatening anything. He's not going to have any check. It's his only check, but I take. So let's go here. It's expected. Now, if he wants to just threaten this again, could go for a queen trade. End up taking here, and then I could threaten his bishop. Or actually, if he goes here, I bring the queen back, trade queens, pawn, and then I fork here. Yes, that is, I think that's the best plan of action, but the question is does he want to trade? Okay, so that's exactly what we get. Very nice. Now, he does have this check, which will allow him to... which will allow him to be alright. Or no, he doesn't, because I just take my pawn. Silly me. Okay, but he has this check, okay. But then, I'm still fine. Because I'm still attacking these two pieces. So what does he do here? I mean, take here. Then I take. What else can he go for, really? Oh, and he just resigns because he's going to be down a piece. All right, cool. Not too shabby. Yeah, I mean, the advantage wasn't even crazy. It was only 1.5, but I guess he didn't want to play on. Very quick player. Seemed to be rushing many of his moves. All right, let's go into the review. 82% accuracy. I did have one blunder, one miss, and one mistake. So, let's see. Typical book opening for the Karo Khan. Okay, let's see my stats. I've won 112, drawn 19, lost 105. Okay. Yeah, I probably should do a course on the Karo just to better know my skills. Okay, so we get to this point, and it says Rook AC1 is a blunder. Oh, because because of the pawn. Okay, yeah, I did blunder the pawn there. And it gives him quite a good advantage. It's a -2. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, but yeah, we handle the situation well. He doesn't capitalize. Okay, and then this is a blunder. Oh, okay. Gotcha, because when you take this pawn with the knight, Okay, yeah, because if you ch try to take with the rook here, you take with check, and then you just up a piece. Okay, gotcha. Gotcha. Let me get back to the point I was at. All right. Yeah, queen takes that, and then I want to keep the queens on the board, so I move my queen here. So I missed that opportunity to win that pawn. Okay, so now he's just up two pawns. Oh, you allow the opponent to eventually win a queen. Huh. So if he goes here. Ah, okay. So I would have to take here because then he's threatening this, right? Because then what happens if I don't take, if I just go here? This. Then what though? Take. And then he's just up. It's a 5 point advantage. That's crazy. Okay. So I did miss that, but he missed it as well. He did not play bishop there. Yeah, he plays knight here, attacking this. He was playing very fast. He didn't spend much time thinking. Okay. And then yeah, this gives away a free pawn. I see that. I almost didn't see it. And then here, there's a better way to bring the queen to safety. Oh, whoops. Wrong best move. Okay, puts down the safer square. Okay. The engine like that square better. Okay, yeah, then I'm just shuffling my queen around, trade. And then, yeah, I calculated this line here, or this outcome. And then, yeah, resigns. Okay, so at the end, it is. I'm up 3.8. When I originally was on the screen, it didn't look like the advantage was too high. But yeah, he just resigns here because I'm going to win this bishop. But cool. Cool. I think if my opponent took a little bit more time with his moves, it wouldn't have been such a swift win. But nonetheless, I love beating a Carl Kahn player because I don't any of the defense, the correct defense. But it seems I do play the correct most part, 2 point, or for the advanced variation at least. But yeah, cool. All right, we're at 14:42 now. Let me go back to this. Oh, whoops. I just wanted to show 1700 it rates me for this game. But yeah, cool. Road to 1500.